Claire Harvey will now introduce the Shahs.
Hi, I have great pleasure to introduce Dr. Atul and Rupa Shah. India and the Himalayas have been very much close to my heart. And when I heard of the Shah's work, must have been about 4 or 5 years ago, I immediately searched to see where they were here in England or in any part of Europe and couldn't find any. So the next port of call was to fly to India to see the Shahs and to see their work at their clinic in Bombay. Little did I know that they were coming over here to meet me, which is our standard joke. And finally we meet here today or yesterday, and they already feel like old friends. Not only have they researched extensively into the Himalayan flower essences from both their medical and their intuitive background, but lately they have been looking at the increasing levels of radiation and pollution on the planet. And they've done some fascinating research on this level. And they have some fascinating stuff to share with us today. So without too much more ado, it's my delight to say Dr. Rupa and Atul Shah.
Good morning, everybody. I'll start with word Om, and I want everybody to join. We'll speak for 3 times. That will give the vibrations, Om vibration, which is a very, very special vibration that you will feel it. All the work in India, we start with Lord Ganesh. That is like you start any work, you talk about one word for God Ganesh, and then we start our work. Now, I would request all of you to join me after I say Om. We'll say 3 times. Om.
Namaste from Bombay, India. Namaste means I and you are one. And I bow down to the highest self in you. Next. And welcome to all the delegates for the conference. Next. Now, we both are trained in allopathy. And my husband, a radiologist for 24 years, and I am a family physician for last 14 years. My husband was trained at the Sloan Kettering Hospital in New York, and he was doing his MRI studies in oncology, cancer patients. And something happened. He thought that I tell all my patients that you have 3 or 6 months to die, and he was feeling very bad about it. He said there must be something that a physician should do, to heal them. He came back home to India, and he started searching for all the different systems of healings, alternative medicines, and he came to meet me about more than 12 years ago, and he was asking me, I've heard about this thing called homeopathy, and those little pills, I think they work. And Next, I gave him a box of bark flower remedies. And I said, this is just water and brandy. Try it out. And so coming from your orthodox background, this was too much for him. But he had open mind. He started them, you know, giving it to the stammering patients. And he said, oh, this thing called stammering improved. And there's something to do with mind, and these remedies are doing what it says. So luckily, we both had open mind, like Dr. Henman, who discovered homeopathy, and we both covered the same journey as Dr. Bach, from allopathy to homeopathy, and then on to the flower remedies. We both were having a separate practice, making, using the Bach flower remedies. We both thought there must be also the Indian flowers doing something. And we started out, in the beginning, we knew nothing. And we made some remedies, we kept quiet, because coming from very skeptical mind, you want to examine everything. But the flowers showed the power, and we had to accept it, that they work. And then we have never looked back. All these 10 years, we made this as a mission in our life to be a bridge to the orthodox medicine and the alternative medicine doctors. And I'm sure you will all agree that when we stand here and talk and show all the results and speak in the language that our colleagues would like to hear, they will be more than happy to accept that this is also a system of healing. Now, I would like to, you know, thank all the devas, you know, who have helped us in our work all these years. For without their help, we cannot move and nothing could have happened. So it's my little flower meditation that I would like to do for a half a minute. Okay. Now, we wanted to actually, both of us, do a lecture on the Indian Himalayan flowers, and we wanted to show you, you know, the beauty of Himalayas. It's very pristine, clear, you know, and it's quite mesmerizing, the mountains, and the beauty is incredible with very rich flora. But we also had this other topic where we do a lot of study, where we study the environmental stress, electromagnetic pollution, chemical pollution. Like, we're talking about what mess we have made, we better clear up. So Dorothy asked us that it would be better to talk about this in the main hall so that everybody comes to know about it and how we can use flower essences to heal, you know, and restore the balance. So we did a workshop on Monday where we showed all the different flowers of the Himalayas and how we use in our practice and quite a few cases. So in today's talk, talking about harmony with the environment by using the flower essences, you may not get to see many flowers or the slides of nature, but there are some other important topics that we would like to talk about today. It's a very different topic. Next. We are made up of the same stuff as what is in the universe. There's a very strong link between us and the nature. We are not separate. All our exchange of information with outside world occurs through our own energy field. There's a constant interaction going on at all times at the energetic level. There is exchange of energies. Next. We constantly reflect every tiniest movement or change occurring around us in the universe. Not only everything in the universe has an effect on us, but we also have a significant impact on the universe as we are constantly exchanging energies, and we too are powerhouse of energies. As it is said, microcosm and macrocosm. We are the universe. Right. Now, the different types of disharmonies, you know, in the environment. The first one is electromagnetic pollution. You can see the slide of different stuff, you know, different kinds of radiation. all the appliances in your house, like microwave, grinders, food processors, computers, telephones, televisions, Xerox machines, air conditioners. They are everywhere. They are on you with a cell phone, right?
You will be wondering that how can you say that? Somebody asked me yesterday, do you think that in the food kept in the refrigerator can have any effect on us? Yes, we have got a tri-field meter with which you can measure how harmful the radiations are there. And not only just to show you, but we have made the device also that we'll talk about it. But to give you idea that even the negative vibrations can come from your washing machine, which is you put it, the electromagnetic pollution come in your clothes, and those clothes you are wearing for whole day. So just imagine what can happen to that. Chemical pollution, you can try.
Pesticides, herbicides, chemical fertilizers, hormones, food additives, harmful chemicals in medicines and drugs. You can see this CFC.
In this, I wanted to tell you that for increasing the size of the grape, they use xyloric acid. That's a hormone that they give it to the grapes, you know, they spray it so that the grape size is increased. And they are harmful to our health. But to yield the more size of the grape, that's what they use it. And these are the things which we are not aware about. It can be so harmful to our health. Which are the areas in our body gets affected? We will be talking in the lecture. Next slide.
Then radiation problems from nuclear disasters, from power reactor waste. Recently, I read a report on internet that they tried to dump, you know, some nuclear waste somewhere, and there were people not knowing, you know, this waste is lying there, working in the area, got radiation illness. So it's a real problem. Then computers, television, x-rays, you know, at the airports, you're all the time going through the machines. Then, if you think you can go to the jungle and meditate and nothing will come, then you have satellites. We are completely covered, okay?
Whether it's FIndhorn or New York or in Sydney, wherever you are going to get this. And there is something you have to find out to prevent and protect yourself from getting these harmful vibrations.
Next. Right, there's another one. That's called as have a glass of water, but what it has with all this, you know, pesticides, malaria control, DDT, which is banned, you know, organophosphorus poisoning, and all this, and what it all gets into your water. Next. So this says all the different kinds of, you know, stuff that you find. The water that we get in home is not clean. It's got chlorine, fluorine. It's got even sometimes lead leaking out, you know, from the pipes. So sometimes you can detect, sometimes you cannot detect. Also, there is another thing apart from the chemicals. It's called as electromagnetic memory. Doing all our flower remedies in water, we know water has memory. Even when you purify water, you know, you remove everything, it still has the memory of the substance that were already in it. How will you remove the memory? Next. So, do you still want to have a glass of water?
Yeah, and this is the water which was offered to us here. And I'm going to give demonstration, live demonstration. Those who are interested, come forward and taste this water. And then we'll neutralize in 15 seconds, and you can taste that water. You will see a tremendous, I gave just demonstration before starting the lecture, and a couple of people could appreciate the difference immediately.
And also remember this, the most water available is dead water. It doesn't have the energy, you know, of the spring water or the natural water.
This is very important that the all the food that you have has also living energy, healing energy. These are the things which are very important, you know. And if the living energy is not there, that water has got no value. It's not going to help you at all.
Next. Okay, air. Where is the place on this planet of pure air full of pranic energy? It is so heavily polluted with toxic chemicals, resulting high amount of allergies and asthma. Negative ions are less and radon level is high at times, right in your own home. Next. Then there are other sources like textiles, you know, the clothes which you are wearing might be dyed with harmful chemicals. Then when you wear synthetic material, you feel very tired because, you know, depletion of negative ions. Even sometimes when you say it's 100% cotton, it's not organically grown and it has got the chemical memory in it. There are also radio and microwave, you know, pollution. The human body works like an antenna, absorbs radiations, results in chronic ill health, it lowers immune system, and also there are neurological symptoms. Next. Okay, what about the garbage? Garbage that we create every day. We do not know where to dump. Is it biodegradable or not? Then there are personal care products like perfumes and things, pet care products, baby care products, and building materials and furnishings. These are all the sources of ill health. See people working in the garbage. Next. So the list is endless. This is your home, anybody's home, and we can show you all the different potentially harmful items in your home. You have lawn and garden stuff, household cleaning products, pest controls, Xerox machines and printers, you know, with the dye. Next.
Yeah, wait. Here.
Just a moment. Yeah, the previous one.
Can you go back to previous slide? I want you to appreciate that difference in a, not only from this, but according to the feng shui also, one has to keep into mind feng shui. In India, we call vastu, V-A-S-T-U, vastu, and the people here say feng shui or geomancy. So they need to balance those five elements. And there are so many things which is like, if you have more fire element coming from a heater, you need to know that that need to be balanced from particular corner. Otherwise, people are going to get, so those person who has got more fire element in their body, it is going to add that fire element because they are, so we have to take into consideration feng shui also, the balancing of fire elements. Another important thing I would like to say, people sleep with that alarm clock, which is electrically operated one. Lot of electromagnetic pollutions come from that also. And there is some research, it's not we have done, but somebody has did say that if you put off your television, the radiation continues to come even 3 to 4 hours after that. So if, like in India, there are houses are small and people sleep very near in the bedroom also, they've got a TV, television or something like that. They sleep very near to television. When the television is off also, the radiation continues to come. And that can cause the damage to the aura. Okay.
Next.
Next slide.
Okay, so effects of all this we label together as environmental stress. And what is the effect of all this on us? Next. Now, you can have the studies done in various parts of the world say increased risk of cancer because of electromagnetic pollution, chromosomal aberrations, suppression of immune system, disturbed biological clock, increases in miscarriages and birth defects. My dear friends, the hazards of electromagnetic pollutions are real and we need to be aware about it. Take precautions, okay? Next.
Next slide.
What is recognized as environmental illness? It's a disease process primarily triggered by environmental stress overexposure. asbestosis, mercury poisoning, formaldehyde sensitivity, etc. Lead, pesticides, harmful fungi and bacteria. And there is also chemical sensitivity. I'm sure sitting here in this audience today, many of you must have heard about chemical sensitivity. People cannot take this, allergic to... So that's the part of the environmental illness. And it affects, the electromagnetic pollution affects all the acupuncture meridians in your body.
Aura.
In your aura, it affects your energy field. Next. What are the signs of environmental illness? Unexplained weakness, temperature intolerance, skin symptoms, swelling of eyes and feet and hands, memory loss, irritability, fatigue, and food intolerance. You can see the energy field can get disturbed because of also what is called as geopathic stress. Next. Okay, there's one more thing that's called as sick building syndrome. New carpets which are treated with a range of chemicals can give extreme reactions in people who are chemically sensitive, like headaches, burning feelings in the lungs, rashes, etc. Air in the air-conditioned room can be dangerous for some because of high level of harmful bacteria and chemicals circulating in closed spaces. Also, because living in very tall buildings, people don't have fresh air, they are disconnected with nature, there is an overstimulation of nervous system. This is also recognized as sick building syndrome.
Cancer. I would like to tell you one example of one, how a cancer patient in New York, in Denver, this patient was suffering from CA breast, and we asked him the history that what happened, and they said that they came from New York to Denver, and for last 1 year they have been staying in this building. It was a very nice place, and they got it very cheap because the person who was staying before them was suffering from cancer. Okay, he had a brain tumor, and he died. So they bought this, and they were staying there. Now, that was like a, this is a called a sick building again. Geopathic stress was coming from that place which had given cancer to that patient, and now these people were staying, this couple was staying, and they were staying in the same bedroom, and she got the cancer. So sometimes it you will be wondering that what can be, and in the geopathic stress, I don't know you know about it, there is something called as Hartman's line, Curry's line, and telluric influence. Telluric influence. This is a something, this is underwater current, which may be about 100, 200 feet below the house. And if it is passing in one direction and your bed is across that, okay, it generates the electromagnetic pollution, and then you land up into a ill health.
Next. Then radiation sickness. So, since we are bombarded with radiations all the time, all these symptoms like fatigue, nervousness, oversensitivity to external influences, and blood disorders.
I showed this slide because this is a case of a leukoderma, but I know for certain that this patient is getting this problem because of electromagnetic pollution. I have very early right now some success in treating the leukoderma patient by giving them anti-allergic devices which will neutralize the food. It's my very a minimal experience I have got, but I have got some success with 4 patients. So I'm working on that, so that probably leukoderma maybe will be able to tell that this could be because of electromagnetic pollution that is happening. Pardon me? Leukoderma. Yeah, vitiligo and leukoderma, yeah.
Next. And multiple allergies, of course. We were never exposed to such a high amount of allergens before. And the immune system is constantly at a loss to figure out and fight new substances. Do you all agree? Yes. Every year in America, they keep listing new carcinogens, right? This results in a long list of allergens, you know, the food, personal care products, paints, clothes, air, etc.
I want to emphasize that for a whatever we say, for a good health, one should have good food, good seeing with the eyes, good listening the things. If you are going to see pornography and then if you are going to talk about spirituality, it's not going to work, okay? So the eyes is getting them, one vibration to the brain, and then your mental level other. So it's a good music that you listen that has got a positive vibration. Good food. I worked, now you must be wondering that in this flower remedy conference, what we mean is flower, gem, and other things, essences. In this essences conference, why this topic? What we have done is made the devices which neutralizes such food which has been there. Now, it's not possible for you, everybody, to know you are allergic to what. So what we have done, instead of going for a long list of, and you go to the doctors and they will say that you will have to test, you are allergic to male cockroaches and you are allergic to dust and you are going to, so many things when they talk it, you know, where you are going to search for male cockroach in the house, you know. So instead of that, what we thought that we made these devices which will neutralize the food and keep you free from allergy. I had one good example. I would like somebody to later on to come forward and tell what happened to him. He was allergic to dairy product, and we neutralized here in Scotland only, and how he responded to that treatment. Next slide.
And the last one on the list, chronic fatigue syndrome. How many of you know someone who has chronic fatigue syndrome? Already, lots, right? It's a new disease. Got five different names and volumes of paperwork. Surely in the, so that's what I talked. And so I think it's the total disharmony with the environment is one of the cause of chronic fatigue syndrome. Emotional imbalance, mood swings, extreme irritability, there's a suppression also of emotion. They of course are very tired. That's the biggest thing. Next. Okay, now how do we attain to harmony and use the knowledge of flower remedies? We all took flowers, we made the remedies, and we all healed ourselves. Now it's time that we give back the flowers to nature and heal our environment, the mess that we have created. This is the slide of lotus flower. The lotus grows in dirty, muddy water, and it has got the capacity to transform, and out comes out a beautiful flower fragrance. And it's a very powerful flower remedy that we use in many of our different situations in life. Next. Okay, for electromagnetic pollution, what can we do? If I tell you to throw the refrigerator out of your house, then let me tell you, there was a recent study done, published in newspaper, saying that more women think that refrigerators are more important than husbands. So you are not going to throw them, you're going to keep them. And we all are going to eat food that is kept in the refrigerator, which has got a very high amount of electromagnetic pollution energy coming. You know that the fruits that are kept outside taste much better than the one which were kept in refrigerator. So we, with the help of knowledge of flowers, for many years we kept on thinking, how can we help to restore the energy that was lost because of the pollution and the food modified itself? We took the flower remedies and we put them in the crystal powder, and when we put the food over that, it changed the taste and it restored the energy. Then it was convenient over a period of time to take the little crystal balls and put them in various different flower remedies or gems or herbs which were very good for neutralizing the pollution, and these beads were saturated for a long time. And after that, we made little devices like this. Now, when you put your food taken out of your refrigerator or your microwave, and you see in 20 seconds, the food restores the energy. It takes on the energy, you know, the healthy energy of the flowers.
This is very important. I want to talk about is this, that it not only neutralizes the negative vibrations, but it energizes the food also. Okay, that's something, two things are different, and you will see immediately the change in the taste, the effect of it. If you are going to drink this water which has been neutralized, and you will see that how energetic you feel it. If you are going to wear these devices where to prevent you from the electromagnetic pollutions coming from satellites, and you are losing the earth energy, what is called as a 7.83 hertz of energy, natural magnetic energy, which is there, is lost because of putting a lot of iron bars, and you see a lot of gadgets that are there of metal, which will block the energies. To get that energy back, you if you wear this, you will see the change in. This is what I want you to appreciate, and why we thought, you know, that where can we? One thing we know for certain, that Himalayas are fairly free from pollution. I don't say 100%. It's fairly free from pollutions. And we went there and we saw that there are certain areas by dowsing, by meditating, and by intuitions, and we saw that these areas are free from problems. And that areas where we picked up certain Indian herbs, in some flowers, and made these essences. And then in these essences, these crystals, the metal rings, were dipped for long time, for about anything from 15 days to 90 days. And then they were ready for neutralizing the radiations.
Next. So they look like this. You know, there are different kinds, and sometimes we use pyramid shape of crystal, and sometimes we have different types of crystals like rose quartz or clear or garnets, you know, different types for different purposes.
There may be different crystals, and in the center, for one device itself, there may be two different type of crystals, there may be different rings. There may be only single metal ring of brass or copper brass combination, or only copper. And this is a device which is called as an environmental stress eliminator. This is something really great. There is a pyramid inside which has been charged by all the flower remedies, gem remedies, and Indian herbs. And the area that it covers is about 500 meter radius in sphere. In spherical, so it's down, up, on the side, either side. Okay, next slide. Okay, this is again the device for neutralizing the water, what we call as a amrit water. Amrit water is a nectar water, okay? And those who want, they can come here and taste this water, and how in 15 seconds they will see the change in the taste of the water. This is a device that is for jet lag, and trust me, those who had already experiences here, like we came from Bombay to London, it's 9.5 hours of flying time, and you add few hours before and after, and got down, immediately went into underground in London, and you know that underground has got so much of electromagnetic pollution. Again, travel for 2 hours, go there and get ready in another half an hour, and then we had three meetings for 9 hours. And next day we are here, and we were fine. It's not that, but definitely, it will definitely help you to prevent. It's a wristband type thing. You can keep it in your pocket, or you can use this device. The idea again is that, not that I'm something, I want you to just understand the power of flower remedies, which can be extended. If I tell you don't go by plane, it's not possible. Don't use computer, it is not possible. But this type of devices, if you keep it, it will definitely, if not eliminate completely, reduce to great extent the electromagnetic pollution that comes. And not only that, you know for certain that food that you get it, yes, somebody is going and taking the cell phone. I'm going to show you the next, that only. So this device, this device, if you keep it, if you keep on this device, the food that you get in the plane, in 15 seconds, you will see that there is a change in the taste of the food also. You know, first food is also prepared in microwave and other things in the plane, and that has got a lot of electromagnetic pollution. Many people get problems after this because of the food that they eat in the plane. Next. Examples of flower essences. These are the flower few that we can tell you that this is a lotus flower and office flower, morning glory, sacred basil, neem, teakwood, carvi, tora rosae. Now, I will quickly tell you about this office flower because everybody would like this. This flower we call as office flower because it opens at 9 o'clock in the morning, closes at the 5 o'clock. And people who are going and working in the office from 9 to 5, you can understand that amount of, they are all the time in the office, not seeing that, not getting that natural energies. For them, this is a wonderful flower. It is also good for the people who have got skin problem, who are working on computers all the time, they're getting the radiations. This is the one of the flower that you can think of. Next slide. And then there are a few gems and stones that we use, clear quartz, Herkimer diamond, regular diamond, peridot, garnet, green onyx, and orange aventurine. These are the few things, and some agates also. I have also tried with some fossils, okay? And we've got wonderful results with that. These are the special ones which are rarely available that we have tried then. Next. And then Indian herbs. Just to show you that some of the names are there, Kalanda, Madhuka, Ambulika, Vasaka, Primula Bhuti, and Corydalis.
And this is the lotus root. Sometimes we take the energy of the root also. Next. Okay, so some of the rectifiers that my husband already told you, food allergy, computers and monitor rectifier, environmental stress, then one for your microwave, also water, cell phone, a little button that you put on your cell phone. The cell phone is emitting a very high frequency between 800 and 900 kilohertz, so it goes right in your brain.
Yeah, it goes up to gigabytes also.
And of course, if you prepare juice in your hand mixie, and the one which you prepare, you know, with the electric grinder or juicer, you know the taste is very different, right? The one which you prepare in your electric juicer, you know, is tasting little, you know, different. It's not that sweet. It's bland kind of thing. In India, we make chutneys, you know, you grind them on the stone, the green color thing, and it tastes very good when you do it on the stone. And but now every home, there's an electric grinder, and we make chutney in that. It gets spoiled very fast, and it's not as tasty. So these are the different kind of neutralizers. Next. Okay, now we have also one more thing that is called as sprays. Apart from using all these little rectifiers, there are also other energies in your environment where you can spray the flower essences. You know, you prepare different kinds of sprays and you can balance the energy in your environment.
And these are one of the four types of sprays that I would like to just quickly tell you about it. Okay.
See, we don't use the CFC kind of, you know, the cans, but just a simple one, you know, where you can just spray around. So there's no chance of adding, you know, to the chemical pollution. Next. Okay, there are four kinds of sprays we've prepared. Aura sprays, that works on the energy field. Then there are elemental sprays, then chakra sprays, and also some general sprays. Next. Okay, the aura sprays.
Yeah, there are four types of aura sprays, which is called as aura cleansing, aura balancing, aura purifying, aura strengthening, and fifth one is aura protection. I'll just tell you the four, how to remember these things. When you go to church, temple, mosque, anywhere, you take bath, and so clean yourself, that's cleansing. You go and sit down in the church, it's aura balancing. Then you get blessings from the priest. They put holy water or something like that. That's aura purification. And the last but not you, once you come out of the church, your aura is very much strengthened. This aura strengthening. This does not mean that you don't go to temple or church. This is just to remind, just tell you that this is what happens when you take those aura sprays, and it would give us almost similar effect.
Next. There are also elemental sprays to balance the energies of five elements in the environment. Now, earth, water, fire, air, ether. That's the one which we use in Ayurvedic classification. You can also use it according to acupuncture. What we do, there's also this ancient science of Vastu. That's like Indian Feng Shui, where we study the different directions, the energies of the different directions, the deities sitting in the place that where you live, and how do you balance and invoke the energies. It's a whole science. And how your health can be affected, you know, by this if it is not proper. So some of the flower sprays, you know, are very good to balance, you know, this elemental energies. Next. Next. Chakra sprays also, you see, when we are sitting right in the chamber full of electromagnetic or chemical pollution, chakras are the ones that get very quickly affected. So if you have some flower energies, you know, put to your chakras by sprays, they work very quickly and balance them. Next.
Anyway, in the chakra spray, I wanted to, this is my absolute latest research work, still it's going on. I made a device which will balance all the seven chakras. Each chakra will take 10 seconds to get clean, and then each chakra will get balanced. I don't say energized. If requires more energy, it will be there. If it is sedation required, sedation will be there. This device, just in 4 seconds for each chakra. And I've got some wonderful results. This is a very initial experience, but I thought that I would share with you. Maybe in future, I will be able to tell you more about it. These are the general sprays. There are sprays to help the general body energies according to Ayurvedic principles of three dosha, that is Kapha, Pitta, and Vata. I don't know how many are aware about these terms, Kapha, Pitta, and Vata. So they divide into three different type of three doshas. And the sprays can be are made accordingly. In fact, our lot of flower remedies are also classified according to Kapha, Pitta, and Vata.
Next. Okay. There's one thing I would like to say, that we do not cut flowers as far as possible in preparing flower essences, thereby maintaining the ecological balance. Initially, when we wanted to make flower remedies, we contacted there's a Bombay Natural History Society, and the lady over there didn't want to help me because she said that you are going to rob earth of all the flowers. I said, no, it's a very different system. Then I explained to her what we do. She was most delighted to help us. So they're very concerned about ecological balance. Next.
And here we have developed a small device. Let me explain you that there are many people who make the flower remedies according to their way. But what I have done is a small device of glass apparatus. It's a small apparatus having us three stages. I think I will show you later on if anybody is interested on that. Draw the diagram and show you that I could not bring it, you know, because it's a glass and it was breaking every time. So it's a small, nice device. And what I have done is divided into three parts. The top part has got a funnel type of thing where the water goes. In the middle part is a flask which has got a hole on one side. So the flower is just turned into that apparatus and the water drops from above and gets collected below. So you don't cut the flower, just take the whatever the energies, whatever the time you want, and then leave the flower like this. Just turn it into the flask and then it goes off. This was, then we have made a lot of modifications that we have used the spiral energies and different type of the clockwise energies. So it is adding the energies to the flower remedies that we are making it.
Next. And of course, no animal trials.
That doesn't mean we do only human trials.
See, we are against trying remedies, you know, for animals. We contacted the biggest hospital for cancer in Asia, in Bombay, and we asked them that we made all these remedies and they seem to be working very well. Would like to give it to the patients. So, oh no, first we have to try them on the mouse, okay? I said, no, I don't want to do that.
So they wanted to induce the cancer in the mice and then they wanted to try our remedies. And it was very difficult for me to explain them that this is not the way it works. But anyway, now there are 16 hospitals, nursing homes that are there. They are taking our flower remedies and using it. We have crossed almost, in last 12 years, we have crossed almost 13,000 patients by this time, treating this further. I'm going to show you all the a few cases of this also to make you feel that how beautiful the flower remedies can work on a physical level also. Yeah. Next slide.
Next. Okay. To restore Mother Nature, how can we use flower remedies? Okay, flower essences or the sprays can be used locally over the plants or the area which might be damaged because of abuse of chemical fertilizers or has negative energies. We can grow also some beneficial plants or trees around your home or office to reduce the effect of the stress. Next. Okay, when you are building your house, on selecting land, one can add flower essences to the land before constructing. Some of our friends have done this. They took, you know, the bottles of flower remedies and they just sprinkle around the land to change the energy before they want to begin construction.
And lotus was one of the flower which was tried on about 10 places where they were feeling that there are negative energies. And they are doing, they have constructed the house, they could construct the house much faster than what they had planned, you know.
Also, when you are painting your home, you can put flower remedies in it and maintain the energy.
What we did in our this medical center where we are working right now is that we painted not only from inside but from outside also we have put this flower remedies. And I will quickly tell you one example of one our patient, you know, who was a little skeptical because his wife was coming and taking treatment, and but he was a little skeptical about that whether this would work or not initially. And then they became my student, and they, after learning this flower remedies, they came to know about this environmental stress elimination. One fine day, he walks in my clinic. He says, Dr. Shah, I want to tell you one thing, that I was completely stressed. I had so many problems. When I walked in your clinic, I don't something happened. So I think this is something, some vibrations are there. Totally materialistic person like me in past, you know. I was always laughing about my wife when I met her for the first time about 10 years and 9 months and 20 days. I remember that she showed me the pendulum dowsing and I said, wow, you are moving your hand, you know, like this. And you know, and now I'm doing so much of it, you know. It's like just it came to me one fine day and I started doing it and I'm getting wonderful results. All these things, let me tell you that a lot of things we do it by finding out by dowsing that which are the right things, and all these devices we made it, we find out by dowsing also. I would welcome anybody who is interested in finding out with the kinesiology, with dowsing, they can check these things. Next slide.
And when you are already ill because of environmental stress, how you can heal? Of course, you can heal with the flower essences. You can take this formula, protection from environmental stress. And also there are some other, like for radiation, and of course all these rectifiers that you can use. Next. Okay, we would like to share a little bit about the research, because all along we are all the time, you know, pressurized, counter-questioned, you know, probed by our colleagues, and asked us all the time, have you done any double-blind studies? Have you done any laboratory testing? So we had to gear up and, you know, answer in their language. So we both are also doing a lot of research to
validate,
you know, the efficacy of flower remedies. And I'm sure in the audience today, there are 12 doctors, and we would also like to be the leaders in this field and invite them to start using the flower remedies by convincing them with this research. There are many ways. I'm still constantly looking out for new ways of, you know, convincing them. Okay, the pendulum dowsing, Kaelian photography, aura biofeedback photography, then kinesiology, then in the laboratory also, the on the petri dish you can see the antibiotic sensitivity test, how it is done, antifungal. So all these different ways we have done already to show that flower remedies do work even in the laboratory. Okay?
We have to do that. Let me tell you one more thing that very recently I have tried on some patient who was on intensive care unit with a cardiac problem, and I gave him this environmental stress elimeter in his hand, and we could see the change in ECG occurring only in 10 minutes. This is the one thing, and I'm going to expand this, my work, into cardiology also to show that how this can help to the patient.
So,
thank you.
Then those who know how to use this can, you know, systematically measure all the different energies, which organs it works. So we collect the data from our friends who are quite expert, and we were so interested, so we also learned how to use the antenna. Next. Okay, we also did some sprout experiments. Now what you do, you take water that is kept on your television, then you take normal water, and then you take water where the neutralizer was on the computer or the television, and then you grow sprouts and compare the growth of all these three or four things. Now the one with the normal water had normal growth, the one which was exposed to television radiation had retarded growth, and the one where the neutralizer was on had more than normal growth. So the life force is restored and it is enhanced.
So this is what I was telling you, it not only neutralizes but energizes also this water. And to our surprise, that when we did this experiment, we left this all the things. When we thought that the experiment is over, we went out of station. After 3 days, when we came back and we were in the laboratory, we saw that still the sprouts which were on the water, which was not neutralized one, were dead completely. With the normal water had something growing, and this with the water which was neutralized, with the television water which was neutralized one, had a still growth. So it could withheld the stress that would come because of no water at all. There was no water. Still they were surviving it. Not completely, but few were definitely there. That itself is telling that they had a power to fight more. And one of the thing which I think like this, going into it, is that this personal rejuvenator which we have made, I have a very short experience, but I would like to share this, which I hope that I am not finished by this, is that you can try this for the AIDS patient because it boosts up your immunity. And it's totally harmless, you can just keep it. And there are many people who have tried in last 4 or 5 days, and they said that how much is the energy in this. Next slide.
With the AccuTech machine that measures the energy in the meridians, you can see before and after the change in the energies of the meridian. So, my friends, does it make sense? They like this kind of graphs, so it's for them. Okay.
Okay. You can see immediately it was only in just 10 minutes the change in the my equipment. It was my pictures, right? These are, yeah. These were my pictures which were taken. And you can see the difference between the top one and after taking this gadget, you know, this type. It was not this exactly, but this type of gadget which was there, holding it and balancing all the meridians. You know, it's coming up straight.
Okay, next. Also, of course, muscle testing, kinesiology, some other devices, you know, that can also measure energy in the flower remedies.
Next.
We are collecting data.
Next.
Next. Okay. There are also some meters, okay, that can measure the geopathic stress, or hazardous electromagnetic fields, radiation, microwave. So all these meters with which you can measure energies, and then you use the neutralizers and measure the energy again. And so you will be satisfied that now you have helped.
You know why we were standing here? Just see. This is the electromagnetic pollution coming from here. If I'm here, no. You can see here. So this is the one of the way to find out. And there are meters, it is called a tri-field meter, or this is a, with the sound you can find out that what is happening.
Okay.
Next. Yeah, now I'm going to show you some cases which we have done. It's down to earth now we are talking of, that a cancer patient was diagnosed as grade, it's not 3A, it's a grade 4A of non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. And she was 60-year-old female patient in 1991. She came to me a day before when I was to come to USA. And I refused to take this case because I said, I'm out for 6 weeks. They requested me that, please, Dr. Shah, if you don't mind, can you take this patient? I have treated this patient for flower remedies. Patient is still alive. And her husband, who wanted to start therapy, thought that my wife is going to die after some time as such. So he thought that he will start remedies after when he told me I'll start after 1 or 2 months. He died in 91 of heart attack, and this lady is still alive. Okay, and this is the CT scan of this. Can you see the date is 18th March 91? Next slide. And the CT scan shows that how much is the improvement from March 91 to October 91. Tremendous improvement only in 6 months' time. Next slide. Hyperactive children. This is something very good, you know. These are the flower remedies that you can use for a hyperactive. You want to say?
Yeah. Sometimes aura sprays can give very quick results in hyperactive children. This is our observation. When you balance the energy in the aura, they just become quiet.
Next slide. Next.
This is a tassel flower, one of the Indian flowers that we use for hyperactive children. Next. Okay, multiple allergies. Some patients are very sensitive to most chemicals, so they show the signs of multiple allergies. And flower essences, like, not only treat the immune system, but also works on the weak protective energy field of the individual. And also, we have made a food allergy device that helps, and all the allergic reactions, you know, come under control. You can see the allergy to detergent. This lady is having.
Next slide. Only look. This is for the addiction, and we have got a very good addiction program that I will tell you in the workshop that how we treat our patients for addiction. Only thing I'll tell you in brief is that we don't tell patients to stop smoking, stop drinking, or stop taking drugs. We tell them that go ahead, whatever you want to do, take these flower remedies and then bring the changes in them. It's a whole program that we do. Next slide. Yeah, this guy who had lost the hair, and the pity part was that he lost the hair before he got married. It was okay if he was married and he lost. I do understand that. Anyway, we treated him. Next slide. And you see, he has grown the hair completely. Next slide. A case of electromagnetic pollution and how the patients are suffering from that, and you know that different type of problems that can have because of fatigue, leukemias, irritability of nervous systems, and allergies that one can get.
So there was a woman who had her house very near the high tension cable, which we detected the pollution with the meter, and she had to, you know, take care of that.
Next slide.
Yeah, change the house, actually. Computers. How many of us are email fans? Lots of us, right? And taking the email, sometimes we all start surfing as well. We spend many hours.
So you
2 minutes more, 5 minutes more, and we are stuck there.
You can put this device near to your computer, and then you can continue using it.
I know the computer generates a lot of electromagnetic pollution.
Next.
Okay. Obesity.
We'll talk this about in the our workshop, that probably with these devices, I think it's again, it's my hypothesis that this anti-allergen device, which we have, obesity may be one of the thing that is called as an allergy, because obesity may be because of allergies. Next slide.
And pain in abdomen using microwave too much?
Jet lag we have already talked about, so I think we'll skip.
Yeah.
Next slide. Chronic diarrhea, amenorrhea, chronic headache. These are the patients which we had because of electromagnetic pollution, and we treated with our devices, kept it, and remedies like this. Next slide. This is that personal rejuvenator which I was talking about here. You can see this. And this girl was a very interesting case. This was my first patient who treated with this, and she had an unknown palpitation. She was getting it, not getting all right. She had irregular periods. Everything was done only by wearing this. She started, you know, like palpitation disappeared only in 12 hours. Next slide. This is the chakra device which I had talked earlier. So
next.
Small. Next slide. Agriculture cases, plant growth.
Sometimes we are referred by farmers that our land is now toxic because of all the fertilizers that they used, and all that the land is no more yielding. You know, it's just like taking a lot of antibiotics in our body and now nothing works. Do you all agree? It's the same thing. So, just the way we use flower remedies for our body, we can use it for the land, and it restores, you know, the energies and becomes fertile again.
Next.
Isn't it great?
Next. Just as I told you before, that water taste is also changing because of electromagnetic pollution, and you can neutralize that. Next slide. Yes, unfavorable feng shui. These are the things which can harm and imbalance your five elements, and you need to neutralize with those environmental stress eliminator. Next slide. This is a Kirlian photography. This is generally what you would see with the normal picture. This was of an angry man, and then we gave him flower remedy. And after 10 minutes, you can see, next slide. See the blue light coming? Okay, that was on the top. This is called as aura biofeedback photography. Look at this person, and he was supposed to be an angry man. Next slide. You can see on the top the slide how we removed the 9 gems that he was wearing it. So we saw like personal rejuvenator, this was removed, and his original color came, okay? And then after giving him personal rejuvenator like this, you can see that aura again, it's overlapping the slide, but this aura was balanced completely. Next slide. This is of my wife, that aura sprays that we did it. Every minute we took the picture, aura cleansing, aura balancing, aura purifying, and aura strengthening. So that's on the top. Before, when she was stressed out at night, 11 o'clock, we took this picture. Then after aura cleansing, this is what she's releasing her anger. But I was on the left side, and this was on the right side. Next slide.
Next.
Next. She's stopped releasing. Enough of releasing. Anyway, these are the aura balancing, aura purifying, and aura strengthening. You can see how beautifully blue color has come back in our aura. Next slide. This is the device which is called as energy massage stick and meditation stick. Those who want to experience this, they can ask me, they can sit here and try this meditation stick and how beautifully it works. Unbelievable. The thing is that there are two crystals on either sides and have a different energies, and it will really take you into altered state very, very fast. And this is energy massage stick. Many people have experienced yesterday also about this, that how fast it is a pain reliever. Acupuncture points, all these things we are going to talk on our workshop about this. Next slide. This I will quickly tell you about one wonderful case, and this is a case of a patient who was suffering from cystic sarcosis, worm in the brain. Okay, and you can see before treatment, that's in June 95, CT scan shows on the right side edema, that black color, whatever it is, small spot, then white spot and black. All those things are because of cystic sarcosis. And in December 95, after treatment, you can see how beautifully it has reduced. And next slide. Remember this slide, you know, and you can see how beautifully it is healed. It's in 97, right? Okay. It's completely free of symptoms, this patient. And he had a convulsions. He was a very poor patient, and they had come to me for the help, and allopathy medicines were tried, nothing would work. This is another case of an ulcer which has healed completely. My orthopedic friends who are here, this patient has an extra dactyly in the toe, and they said that it will not heal if you don't remove that extra dactyly. But I have treated him, and it has completely healed. Unfortunately, this patient died because of burn accident. It was something, it's a long story, but next slide. Surprise. Next.
Next, please.
I'm going to, by the time they change the carousel, I'm going to tell you that only now only 4 or 5 slides are left. But meanwhile, I'll just tell you that these are the devices. Anybody interested after the lecture, you know, you can contact me or in the afternoon. I'll be here to answer to all your questions. Yes, this was a case of pointer. This was a case of sarcoidosis. Okay, and you can see here the two tumors here. And after the treatment of 3 months, patient is cleared. This patient we had taken to Portland to show it to the doctors there, and they saw that it has cleared completely. Next slide. A very interesting case. I love to show it. This child was an adopted child by the parents, and he had a keratitis, which was, there were a lot of ulcers on the cornea, and patient was turning blind. After 15 years of infertility, they had adopted this child, and then when they came to know that patient is turning blind, they were really upset. They came to me, I treated, and in 1 year's time, he is able to see completely. Okay, and now parents are so happy, they had gone to Trivandrum for, and they, that's a ceremony, they do it and cut the hair and all those things. Next slide. I'm really proud of this patient that he could get the vision back. This was an ulcer before and after treatment, and this is where I say that it's a complementary. At this stage, I gave back to this patient, to plastic surgeon who had failed earlier for plastic surgery. After treating this, he was ready for the plastic surgery and they could do it. Next slide. This was an allergy. You can see something is not, but you can see the red eyes of this patient. It's overlapping, but now it has become white here, okay? So it was an allergy patient which I treated, and he responded in 3 months only, completely allergy-free. It was allergy in the eye, and he had asthma also. This is the patient where I would say that this is a patient and this mother. I treated the mother and not the patient for infantile eczema.
It's good. Okay. We treated mother.
And not the child.
Child condition.
Child condition. Next slide. This is a child. This is a lady again who had a. You can see the white spot in the cornea, and we treated. She could get the vision only 50%, but at least she could get. That's what important was. Next slide. Yeah, this was a case of a fracture which we orthopedics again. You know, this was a non-healing fracture. This is the tip. And this is osteoporosis that occurred. And next slide. And non-healing fracture. We gave him after 6 months of non-healing. And it healed. He started healing. I've got that slide is not here right now. So these are the devices that we use. Next slide. Yeah, and just to tell you quickly all the stresses that one can have, geopathic, you know, allergies, pesticides, and you can quickly go through this. Financial problems. Next slide. And the essence of today's talk is to make everyone think about the following. What is the role of environment in maintaining health? How flower, jam, herbal essences participate in harmonizing our environment? Next. Nature kingdom knows and nature heals. This is the message of every flower and other essences that we take to heal ourselves and our environment. Next.
This is a little poem that I wrote. Thank you, God, for floral gifts. When I saw a flower, I saw you. When I smelled a flower, I smelled you. And when I felt a flower, I felt you. When I talked to a flower, I talked to you. And when I became one with a flower, I was healed and I became one with you.
We are all united and we are all one. We love you all. Next slide. We are coming to the end of the lecture, but there are two flowers which I thought that they were very important, which very important for all these devices that I would like to show you before we finally say thank you to everything. Next slide. Very important flowers. You will never see these two flowers.